Hey everyone, I'm Rob Laura, and this is my 2013 Ram 2500. After 21 years in the service and retiring from the Army, I decided that I wanted to take this 2013 Ram and go ahead and start this Overland build, so let's get into it. As far as the front goes, we got the AEV bumper, 16.5 Warren TI winch here. Went with Baja Design, the Squadron Pros, for the lighting on the front, and then Morimoto headlights and fog lights for the front. Changed the grill to a 2019 grill to color match. AEV hood as far as trying to get some more airflow, and brought it into that AEV snorkel there, but it's the pre-filter, so to keep all the dust out of the engine bay. As far as the suspension, I really went through trying to figure out what would be best for my application for the vehicle. At the end of the day, going with Fox and BDS was the easy choice because of the ride quality that I've experienced in Jeeps as well. So as far as what I did with the 3-inch coilover setup, it gave me that ride height that I needed to clear the 40s, the 3-inch coilover setup, so we went 2.5s. As far as the ride quality, it's phenomenal. Going through the whoops or just bumps in general, it really does absorb that from the front side. Yesterday we ran Hell's Revenge and did Hell's Gate in the truck, and it performed phenomenally as we went through the trail, especially with the 40s and supporting that BDS and Fox setup. From the back side, we went with the 2.0s. Right now, we're looking to modify it with as big as the build is gone. We want to try to get some more fluid in there, so we're gonna be moving to the 2.5s or the 3.0s from the front and to the rear, just to handle how big the vehicle is and the weight. As far as the wheel choice and tires, I decided to go ahead and modify it to get a little more clearance. So I decided to have AEV go ahead and do the fender cuts on there to fit the 40s. 20-inch wheels, they're the Militia wheels from Fuel. And then Razor, the Razor tires, the 40 by 1350 on the Maxxis Razors. Went ahead and decided that I needed to redo the drivetrain on this vehicle for the transmission portion of it. So went with a BD ProForce transmission so it could handle everything I was trying to throw at it, especially being a bigger vehicle. So put that in, new transfer case, new front axle, did the 456 gears, ARB lockers front and rear. Underneath, I went with the PSC Hydro Assist to assist with everything, so got that welded in. And then from there, added a 4-inch intake and boost tubes to help with the EGTs within the vehicle. For towing, and additionally just trying to the mountain passes, we live in Colorado. From the back, I decided I wanted to go ahead and do the tent, just trying to figure out where we wanted to go with it. So we decided to go with 23-0 and talked to Justin down there. He was great. We wanted to make sure that we had a blacked out tent, and so we didn't wake up with the sun. So he worked with us, and we got the 23-0-72 Breezeway, so the California King, and got that for the back of the truck. And we got the awning over here, which is the 180R 23-0 awning. It's meant to go on the back, but I still wanted the side mount, so we had up top had them make the bracket so that it could fit on the side of the truck. And then coming down from the tent, up top was really great with us. We went to them and we wanted a half rack to support everything. I didn't want to go to the full size rack because I wanted to kind of streamline it from there across the top of the bed. So we got the half rack from up top in Denver, and it mounts on a Rototrax bed cover, so it's all functional back there, so I can close it up. Inside the truck, we did a full custom wrap for our, my military service, I went and put my emblem for my squadron in the center, and they went through and took all the electronics, changed out the clusters to match it up from an SLT to a Laramie model. We did that, a new radio system, and then all new speakers all around with a 12-inch sub in the back. Why I built this truck was I've always been a Jeeper. I've built Jeeps and enjoyed it, but at the end of the day, it was a back and forth kind of thing, and I enjoy longer trips. My girlfriend and I, we love to fish and hunt and do those kind of things, and so it was a better fit for me to go to the Overland, but I wanted to make sure I had a full size so I wasn't packing everything into a small box to do these longer trips. So that's why I chose the platform of the Ram 2500. And the 13 model was the last year that had the leaf springs, so that's why I chose that year, because of the pulling a fifth wheel and having that payload. And for these longer expeditions, I really am looking at trying to get longer fuel capacity or a greater amount of fuel capacity for these longer trips. So I'm going to go with Titan tanks to get the replacement that gives me about that 75 gallons with both tanks set in there to accomplish those longer expeditions for myself. I decided to go with the amp research steps and went with the XL to get a little more drop in it with the size of the build that I was going to do. And then additionally, I added the Dynalock hubs from Dynatrack, strengthen out the axle, the front, and they have performed phenomenal locking and unlocking seamlessly, and it's been a huge upgrade to the truck. For the exhaust system, I went with Sinister Diesel. They made a AR-15 rail and that fit the exhaust system, so I went to have that modified. I decided, because of how it sticks out, to get the exhaust out. I knew that wheeling on the departure angles would be a problem, and that would go up into the bed. So I had I modified the exhaust so it dumps right over the axle, and right over the axle I have a quick disconnect to disconnect the whole back part of the exhaust system so that I can go ahead and throw it in the back of the truck anytime I wheel for that departure angle. And right here I have a dedicated onboard air line. Just ported it back here for ease of access for this and my onboard water source. We're trying to get moving in to get a trip into Alaska, move forward into like longer range expeditions, and having the availability to pull up and go ahead and do what we want to do as far as fishing or hunting and not be uncomfortable. And so that's really what inspired us about the whole build and trying to get this set up. And hopefully in the future, we can do those longer engagements where we actually are able to self-sustain, and maybe Alaska, and we would love to do the Mexico Peninsula down there. So